Welcome back to the TSL number 4. I am here with Day 9 himself. We have already seen one hell of an epic series as it did go on to game number 5. One thing I wanted to mention there is Major does advance, but he's going to be going up against the winner of Johnny Rico and Naniwa. Not only can I not wait for Johnny Rico versus Naniwa, but I also can't wait for Major versus either of those players. But anyways, back to this game. Down in the bottom left side, it is going to be Curious. And up in the top right side, it is going to be LaLuSh. Sean, what are your predictions here in this match?
Well, I honestly think it's going to be what goes on with the layer tech will be the interesting decision. As many people painfully lived through the early days of beta in StarCraft 2, where pretty much ZvZ was, well, I'm going to build roaches and you're going to build roaches and we're just going to keep sending waves of roaches at each other, and people would say, no, it's more interesting than that. You can counterattack with roaches. It was just devastatingly boring. However, since the maps have become a little bit larger, people have discovered the strength of Zerglings taking early thirds and relying on that layer tech. I would expect LaLuSh to be doing some interesting stuff with Mutalisks in that mid-game, but Curious, I think, has some of the best bust timings that I've seen of any Zerg player, so I would really love to see some of that aggression out of Curious right at the start of the match.
And you gotta remember that I always accidentally say recent. It isn't recent at this point, but the changes to the Queen means that those Zergling counterattacks are not as effective in the early game. So again, we do see a lot of later games pan out. We don't see Banelings used as much in the super early stage. Not saying it's not effective, but the Queens can snipe those much, much easier. And we do have the expansion. This was an expand first out of both players.
Yep.
Here. Sean, this is something that if I'm Zerg on ladder, you got to be careful doing, but I mean, how does it work since both players went expand first?
Well, already we're seeing Curious basically say, I'm early expanding, I may as well just go all out with it. He went expand, drone, gas, and we see LaLuSh go expand, insta-pool, and then gas. So Curious will be in a little bit stronger of an economic position. When you do these sorts of early expands, there's two big plays that you'll end up making. One is to get very fast Zergling speed, as we're seeing Curious do, and he'll end up going for some big aggression, some attack focus. The other is to get mostly drones and a couple of Banelings and a Spine and rely on that for the early defense. All of the Zerg vs Zerg mid-game is now defined by the speed Zergling rather than the Roach.
We do have the gas for both players now up and running, and you can see just a slight economic edge there as far as the gas is concerned, and the hatchery is going to be finishing up here, I think, almost at the exact same second here.
Bam.
Indeed, they are. Boom and boom. Now, at this point, I mean, this is where the build is going to start diversifying a little bit. We do have double queen on the way, and we do see Curious going to be going for the just single Zergling out. Metabolic boost is on the way. And again, we do see that slight economic edge where he's able to get his stuff just a tiny bit earlier. The queens will be a little bit delayed, but other than that, should be okay. But what are kind of the options here, Sean, now that both players have basically done the same thing?
Now that they're both going for Zergling speed, I think we're going to wind up in kind of a comical position where both players are going for some incredibly aggressive Ling runarounding action. I see you mousing on down to that curious main base where we see the Baneling nest going down. Indeed, two were left in that gas geyser for both players. Yeah, they're literally playing identically right when these larvae pop off. That's when the big floods of Zerglings tend to happen if the players are going to go aggressive. But you know what, Mike? I think they'll probably both just go passive Baneling defense.
Which gets me kind of excited because late game ZvZ on this map is so fun to watch. Have seen it at MLGs in the past and a lot of the online tournaments recently. And you do mention the Baneling Nest. They are almost done. Zergling speed almost done. And this is what I'm talking about. I mean, back in the day you were talking in beta, this was something that was completely unheard of. You were not on Steps of War going expand first into lots and lots of drones with delayed metabolic boost. That just was not a thing. And I'm curious on the units tab here. We do have just 8 Zerglings, some defensive Banelings here. That's going to allow him that if his opponent does a big swell of use, I think both players are actually going defensive Banelings. Where are the two for a blue Zerg player? But either way, nope. Oh, where are they? There they are. So those are actually more offensive. Spotted them on the right side.
Yeah, Curious is really good about this. It's so easy to say, okay, my opponent has an attack. Cool, I can get my defense up. Not Curious. He says, wait, there's been no attack? Oh my god, he's going to try to charge right in with his Ling Baneling, and it looks like Curious will track down those two in the corner and take them out, but not before losing a lot of lings of his own. You know, again, it's so easy to fall into that trap of going, aha, he hasn't attacked me, I'll have an easy time getting my defense up. You have to instantly jump right into aggression if your opponent is being passive. So right now, LaLuSh has probably identified that his opponent is not really doing anything aggressive. LaLuSh now needs to take the opportunity to start pushing back towards Curious.
And right now, the worker count looking almost identical here. We did get a nice swell of drones there from Curious, but got to be following it up is LaLuSh, having seven drones of his own on the way. And Sean, you mentioned the Lair Tech going to play a big role here. We do see Curious going for Lair Tech quite early compared to his opponent, throwing down Evo Chamber and the Roach Warren. So what does that mean? I mean, is he going to be in a good spot with this?
LaLuSh is doing kind of a big Roach mid-game. We're going to end up seeing him get the upgrade and expansion and play somewhat passively, but passive in a very muscular kind of way. You know, there's that sort of passive sit because I'm scared, but then there's the passive because I have so many bases and upgrades coming that you have to kill me off before they kick into gear. On the other hand, we see Curious, interestingly, going for a faster layer, and then Roach Warren. This is very counter to what Zergs are doing nowadays.
And the Zerglings there to defend any counterattacks here with the Banelings is... Oh, needs to be careful. So Tenth does trade two for two, which is okay. And if he can kill these off with just two Lings, that's going to be even better. And he does nice control there. Is not going to be made any major losses there. And all he lost was minerals. Hasn't lost any gas in this, aside from the two Banelings he himself has detonated. But he's going to hold on to this expansion for now. No major damage has been dealt. And this is always a tense moment in ZBZ when you're seeing these Zergling versus Baneling battles. Looks like he will finally clean that up. He does. So LaLuSh is going to be in good shape here. Does lose some of his Lings, though, to that final last Baneling. And the Roach production in full swing here of Curious. He has five on the way, plus one. That Roach speed is being researched here. The Lair Tech now just got to be finishing here for LaLuSh. So, Sean, do you think that LaLuSh is still going to be defensive?
Well, I mean, he kind of has to begin doing something big again because he's seeing no aggression out of his opponent. Curious is going for, now he's kind of backing up to a little bit more standard stuff, now getting the infestation pit and expanding at the same time. Very common timing. We see the same thing out of LaLuSh, but I would love to see a second evolution chamber out of LaLuSh. Maybe an extra macro hatch. Something that really strongly takes advantage of the defensive position that he's in. Right now, we're just kind of seeing more of the same. We see the three spores, but I mean, it's kind of an inactive move. There is a second evolution chamber from LaLuSh. That's the sort of thing that will help him get ahead.
LaLuSh made a lot of spores. We also do see Curious throwing, I think he just made one spore in all, so he hasn't invested nearly as much there. The Changeling almost sneaks into the main base to see what was going on. Did he spot that infestation pit? No, he doesn't know for sure that it's going to be Infestor Tech quite yet. 13 drones on the way for Curious. At the same time, we have 11 roaches on the way for LaLuSh, but you gotta remember that his roach timing was behind, so he's only gonna be equal in roaches once all those roaches actually spawn. The passive lands on the way here for both players. We do have a big attack here from Curious. He is gonna be slipping into the expansion and be able to get a big surround, or not a surround, but a big killing blow on a lot of these drones. He doesn't just have enough here to hold this off. 21 workers killed in this engagement, so whatever advantage he had expanding early is now gone. Loses the queen as well. This could actually put him well behind, as now the base is up and running for Curious here. And
Wow.
That was a nice attack there for him.
You know, this is exactly what makes Curious so difficult to play against in this matchup. There's almost that, like, unspoken gentleman's treaty. It's like, well, we're both taking third, so let's chill. We're both clearly in good defensive spots. But Curious knows just the right times to step in there, strike, and get that 20-some-odd drone kills. And now we see LaLuSh starting to catch up with the Roach speed. I mean, it's so unusual to have, like, Roach speed timings when both players are getting their thirds up at this rate. But LaLuSh now, again, starting to take advantage of the position he's in. We see him getting that macro hatch up, getting the second upgrades up, but I mean, Curious is ahead in all those regards.
And I do even like this nice little touch outside the third base of LaLuSh. The Overlord spreading creep there, that was just going to give him a little extra room to micro that Roach timing. May eventually lose that Overlord because he is kind of in a weird spot where Queens can chase it down quite easily on that creep. But Curious is showing us that he is thinking about his strategy in and out, every little nice aspect of it. And he's going to basically be going all out in this series, which is what we've seen so far. The pathogen glands is done, which means the infestor production has begun. We can see six infestors at the watchtower here for Curious, just beginning to get a lot of energy on those. Whereas if you compare it to M.LaLuSh, he's only got three infestors, now to eight. So I feel like, it's just so tough when you're getting the exact same units as your opponent. How do you get ahead in a battle when you just have less stuff? It can be very, very tough. Might mix in some Hydralis. That's always going to be an option. But I don't know, man. It looks like Curious is going to be gearing up for yet another attack.
Curious has gotten those infestors so early. They've been charging up energy all game long. M.LaLuSh has a few of his own, but not quite that many. It's all going to have to be the defender's advantage that helps him stay alive in this spot. But while all this is going on, Curious taking that extra expansion in the middle of the map. Now he's going to start knocking down those destructible rocks. Burrow is up for M.LaLuSh. But in this position, I mean, Curious just doing a nice job stepping through the middle of the map. But look at the Overlord spread from M.LaLuSh. He sees everything that's going on there in mid-map and sees this attack coming. Ooh, don't lead with the infestors.
Now you have to remember here, Sean, is that if he can defend for, it looks like, 30 in-game seconds, he will have an upgrade advantage, which is kind of an interesting thing.
Oh, and there's the huge fungal on the infestors. Can he get him?
Armor. Does he get him again? He does throw it down. I think he needs a third
one.
Can he get it? Oh, he does get that pop. Oh, a lot of those infestors. It's kind of hard to tell exactly what's going on, but there's a lot of fungals, a lot of infested Terrans. It does look like M.LaLuSh is getting pushed back to Concave,
and
looking phenomenal for
Terrans.
There's
the upgrade finish. That is a big win right there for M.LaLuSh. The fact that his upgrades are done, his reinforcing swell of roaches is going to also pop in. And in that engagement, we see that Curious lost a big chunk of his infestors. M.LaLuSh has stayed alive, but I think the damage was dealt as Curious now has an extra base up.
And units lost over here is favoring Blue Zerg. Economy is favoring him as well. Not only is the base up, but he's also going for that rich Vespine Geyser there, and the drones are ready to transfer inside. Now, with the upgrade advantage, M.LaLuSh needs to push the slight advantage that he has. I think it's the only way he's ahead right now. He's behind in supply, though. Some of that is going to be in the worker count. Not that much, only four supply there, so he's going to be going up against a vastly superior army. Are the upgrades going to be enough? I think getting in some Zerglings or Hydralis or something else just to make his composition a little bit different than his opponent might be what it takes. But no,
yeah.
He says, I'm going to retreat and take my own fourth.
This is kind of a funky position that both these players have found themselves in. Right now, Curious is starting to spine up, but doesn't actually have a hive behind it. That's a little bit of a... It's kind of one of those displays of discomfort. You know, well, I really want to attack, but I don't know if a counter is going to happen. I don't have the good Overlord positioning. Curious is actually banking quite a bit on this attack, and M.LaLuSh, as we've seen, gets the good concaves, and it looks like the engagement is going to go really nicely for Curious based on his positioning. Oh, where are the infestors for M.LaLuSh? Totally out of position. He loses his infestors immediately. Oh, M.LaLuSh in a huge world of trouble.
Yeah, he was able to get the fungals out, but losing the infestors before he's able to dump the rest of that energy. And it looks like Curious throws out a ridiculous amount of infested Terrans, which are just going to clean this up for the cost of energy alone. And I don't think he has an upgrade advantage anymore. No, he doesn't. He does have an armor timing advantage, but unfortunately for him, it is not going to be done in time. His opponent is completely maxed out. He's got his fourth base completely secured, which means that his own fourth base is going to be very undefended. We do see Burrow right here for Curious. He is going to regenerate the HP, getting them back up to full. M.LaLuSh, though, does have a huge army, but I just don't know if it's going to be big enough. It's only 84 to 127. Can he get a favorable engagement here? He would have had to catch all those roaches out of position in the center, but that, of course, is not going to happen. And again, when you have the same unit composition as your opponent, but you're down 40 supply, that means you're in trouble. Though he's down less than that right now as he is able to start maxing out. But we do see Curious going into Hive Tech, knowing that he's already maxed and that there may not be an engagement this second, and working towards Broodlords.
Wow, this is looking really good for Curious, and I don't even think he's going to need to get to Broodlords, Mike. This attack is coming at a terrible time for M.LaLuSh. He has one Infestor out. The Infestor edge for Curious is massive.
He splits up the army and retreats, hoping that the Infestors have wasted all their energy. The Infestors are relatively low on energy here. Can he himself get any big Infestor hits?
Oh!
He does try and kill the Infestors, but guess what? Huge, huge fungals. Got to be chained back to back, but no more energy on those Infestors. So the Roaches just taking damage from the infested Terrans. His concave on the right side pretty good, but it's just not enough. And I think he is going to have to tap out here. It's 148 supply to 193, trying to group his army together, but he is not able to catch back up. He throws out fungals, but there's just no units left to clean out these roaches. And this looks like a slow, painful death here for M.LaLuSh.
A commanding performance by Curious in game number one, overrunning all the expansions, having way more infestors and additional base, and good game! M.LaLuSh.